Shibava so Shepherdova so
Savior of us so Lover of us so
We are on the Lord's side We will never give up We are overcomers For the Lord God is on our side We are on the Lord's side
Aleluia.
Strangers in a strange world. It means I am talking to you directly this morning. It means I'm talking to myself this morning. The strangers in a strange world. Even though you like it or not, children of God, we are living in a strange world. That's why some things, you see some strange things happening that can never happen in where we came from. In where we came from, there are no killings there. Killing is a strange thing to us. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Living in a strange world, where we came from, there is no sin there. Sin must be strange to us. Lying must be strange to us. The thing, sometimes when I look at people dying because of money, because of cars, I marvel. It's strange to me. How can people be killing themselves because of money? How can people be dying because they want to whatever? They are strange to me. You know why? Because I am a stranger living in a strange world. Because I'm a stranger, nothing on this strange world moves me. I don't know about you. You are a stranger in this world, so everything should be strange to you. The only thing that gives me joy, the only thing that makes me happy is when they are doing what they do in my Father's kingdom. Every other thing they do here on earth does not give me joy. Having a very big car that looks like your world does not give me joy. What gives me joy is when they are doing what Sister Wumi was doing just now, praising my Father. You know why? Because that's what they do in my world. What gives me joy is whenever I'm doing what I'm doing right now. Because this is what they do in my world, where I came from. Every other thing happening here are strange to me. But because they are strange to me, they don't move me. I don't know if you have grown to this level of Christianity. That nothing on earth moves you anymore because you are a stranger in a strange world. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bible to the Hebrews chapter 13. Hebrews 11, rather, from 13 to 16. These all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, and we are persuaded of them. And embrace them and confess that they were strangers and pilgrims on this earth. They confess that they are strangers and pilgrims on this earth. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. What are you seeking? Because they knew they were strangers in a strange world, they were seeking another country, which they knew they would be settled forever. Now, verse 15, and truly, if they had been mindful of that country from where they came out, they might have an opportunity to have returned. Verse 16, but now they desire a better country. That is, an heavenly. They desire a better country. Our heavenly, our fathers knew that this earth was nothing before them. They knew that the earth they were living was strange to them. They never care about anything on earth here. They seek heaven. That's why I love that song, someone that says, we are marching to the city where the builder and maker is God. What do you seek? What do you seek as a child of God? But now, they desire a better country. That is an heavenly where God is not ashamed to be called their God. For he has prepared for them a city.
Amen.
This is a consonant with John 14, 1 to 3. I've got to prepare a city for you. I've got to prepare a place for you. That is where our mind should be. Because we are living here on earth as strangers and pilgrims. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bible told us in Genesis chapter 23, Genesis 23 from 2 to 4. And Sarah died in Kajataba, the same is Hebron. Hebron is the land of Canaan. And Abraham came to mourn for Sarah and to weep for her. Verse 3. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And Abraham stood up from before his death and spake unto the sons of Heth, saying, I am a stranger and a sojourner with you. Give me a possession of a burying place with you. I may bury my dead out of my sight. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
People of the land, I am a stranger with you. This should be our language to the people of this earth. This should be the same language we should be speaking to the people of the land we are living. We are strangers here. We are going somewhere. People on earth, we are strangers here. We are not of this land. We are going somewhere. Where is that place we are going to? We are going up there. Heaven. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
1 Chronicles chapter 29, 14 to 16. But who am I? Who is my people? That we should be talking here. People who know what they are doing, not like the Christians of today who are pursuing the things of this world. But who am I? And who is my people that we should be able to offer so willingly after this sort? For all these things come of thee. Of thy own have we given thee. 15. For we are strangers before thee and a sojourners, as we are all our fathers. Our days on earth are as a shadow, and there is not abiding. Our days on earth are as a shadow. We are strangers and sojourners on earth here. Then he said, Lord, we are giving everything you gave to us on earth here back to you willingly. Why? Because they belong to you. We own nothing on earth here because soon and very soon we are going to meet you up there. Soon and very soon, we are going to pass away like shadows. We have no place on earth yet. We have no possession on earth yet. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Our God, all this store that we have prepared to build thee a house for thy holy name, cometh of thy hand, and is all thy own. We are ready to give us anything as far as what pleases our Father. Verse 17. And know also, my God, that thou try the heart and have pleasure in uprightness. As for me, in the uprightness of my heart, I have willingly offered all these things. And now have I seen to sing with joy the people which are present here to offer willingly unto thee. As a pilgrim on earth here, nothing on earth here will be too hard for you to give out.
Amen.
Glory to matter, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
In this time, you are living them. In no distant time, you are living them, and he that gave it to you had the power to take it back from you. But it is unfortunate that the Christians of today, even the telling the Christians the truth, they will gather everything to themselves. They are gathering as if they will live on earth forever. It's not going to be so. Soon and very soon, we will expire. Of earth here. Every one of us have an expiry date. And when the expiry date comes, you will not exceed it. You must live this earth alone. So why are you gathering and gathering and gathering to your own detriment? Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible told us, those who know what they are doing, Job chapter 14, verse 1 and 2, man that is born of a woman is of a few days. Man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. We are encountering trouble every day because we are in a strange land. Verse 2, he cometh forth like a flower and is called hell. Hey, he fled also as a shadow and continueth not. Sister and brother, your grandfather that died some time ago will never come back again. Sorry to say this. Your father that died some years ago, Sister Gift, your father that died some time ago, you lost so much, will never ever come back again. He has flied away with those coconut implanted. You know that? With those coconut implanted, did he eat from it? Yes, more. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
With all the coconut I made in your house, he left all. He left everything. The house that children built for him, he left it. So also all those your Ghana must go up close. All those things you are gathering that is making you to serve God. That car you hold the car key as if it's your first child. You will leave them. You will leave them. You know why? Because you are a stranger here. You will go away. Your father went away. Your grandfather went away. We all will also go away. Do you believe that? Your fast and prayer, if you like, do 300 day dry fasting, and the time comes, you go. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Job chapter 14, 7-12. For there is hope of a tree on earth here. On earth, the earth you are living, tree have greater advantage more than human being. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You are underrating. They have strength and power more than you. Let's go. For there is hope of a tree. If it be cut down, that it will spring up again, sprout again, and that their tender branch therefore will not cease. That's it. Though the roots thereof wax old in the earth, and the stalk thereof die in the ground, yet, verse 9, through the scent of a water, it will bud and bring forth bud like a plant. If a man die, use all the water or earth to water that grave, it will never come back again. Is somebody hearing me?
Amen.
Let Sister Gift travel back home. Carry many, many tanker of water. Go and water your father's grave. For 10 years, your papa, the man will never, ever, ever wake up again. But cut that a tree and bring to pool water. The Bible says it will burn. Mm-hmm. And speak for the game. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Man diet. But man diet are wasted away. The body you are garnishing, the body you are cherishing. Before you connected this morning, you have to bath and bath and bath and bath and bath with, oh, my people, with all the damn brocade you are having. The Bible says you will die, this body will waste away, and if case not taken, if you live in sin, both your body, soul, and spirit will waste away. Everywhere. But man died and waste away. Yea, man give up the ghost. And there is he, and where is he? Sir, where is your father? In my own eyes, I watched my grandmother dying. Mommy, 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 finish. Finish. See, today, the only day I saw again was some time ago when I saw her in a place where I will never want to go, with all her good mind. A very good and caring. She don't have any evil against anybody. She loved to give, but she was not born again. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You love people, but you are not born again. You are going to hell. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There are a lot of good people in hell. There are a lot of people, they never have any problem with anybody. But because that ticket was not there, the ticket of Christ, you will go to hell. Tell your friends who are saying we are good. And that will say be good. Be good. If you are good without Christ, you will crash in hell. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Where is he? Verse 11. As the water fell from the sea, and the waters fell from the sea, and the flood decayed and dried up, so man lie down. So man will also lie down in the 6 feet. The children out of the a lot of money. See, you will never be too rich. The children say, because you are too rich now, let us use 10 clothes to gather you. They will go to market and buy, if they're too much, they will buy you the man's brocade. Praise the Lord. They will buy you flower linen. If they love you so much, they'll say, okay, let us bury him in one of the rooms. Yes, they throw you outside there. You'll be in the rain there with all your labor in iniquity, with all your toiling and laboring. With that car you are saying, hey, this because of this car, because of this, all of them will be on earth here. You know why? Because you are a stranger. They have permanent residence, but you have no permanent residence on earth here. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So man died. So man lay down and riseth not till the heaven be no more. Everyone in hell sees that at their joy. Until heaven will exist forever. If your father is in hell, if your mother is in hell, if your brothers are in hell, they will be there forever. Somebody asked the Lord Jesus Christ, sir, when will these people in hell leave hell? He said, do you want to know? He said, yes, I want to know, sir. He said, until my father be no more God anymore. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Until God no longer be God. That is the only time you that is going to hell now. If you jump into the hell, you will be there forever. Hell will not be your permanent residence. Sir, we're telling you right now. It's not only people who are his that are strangers here. Every human being are strangers here. Before now, I was thinking it's only me, sir. Instead, it's not only you. Both sinners are all our strangers. We that are living for him. When you die, you have a permanent residence in heaven. And those who will also die in sin have their permanent residence in hell. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I pity those who have died already that never heard this message. And I also pity those who are here right now and the message means nothing to you. Your residential villa in hell will be worse. Amen.
Amen.
You that is hearing and you are saying it's not my business. Your residential villa, the cage of fire, they will put you. And you'll be burning and burning inside a cage eternity. Your own will be worse. Your man lie down and raise not. The heaven be not unto the heaven be no more. They shall not awake again, but be raised up out of their sleep. Oh, Jesus. That will not be my portion, Jesus. That will not be my portion, Baba. That will not be my portion, Daddy. Save my soul. Hell is not my portion, Baba. Hell is not my portion, Daddy. Hell is not my portion, Baba. Save my soul. The Bible told us in Psalm 39, verse 12, hear my prayer, O Lord, and give ear to my cry. Do not be silent at my tears, for I am a stranger with you, a sojourner like all my fathers. We are strangers here on earth. Until you get to where we are going to, let us be crying. Jesus, have mercy on me. Father, have mercy on my soul. For I am a stranger here on earth. The Lord, when the Lord Jesus came here on this earth, he knew he was a stranger here. He did everything to make sure he went back to where he came from. Will you go back to where you came from? Nobody came from hell. Sister Indigi, help me to tell my people. Nobody came from hell or earth yet. The Lord Jesus Christ, but today, they are being so from hell anymore. Now, all this, the one they gave back to through her, HIV, IVF, all those that came from the pit of hell. And they will go back to where they come from. There's something the Lord showed to me, I'm not going there now. I pity those people, those who produce them, and those who help them. I pity them. That's not for today. The Bible told us in John 15, 18, and 19, if the world hates you, you know that it hated me before it hates you. You know why? Because we are strangers here. We don't belong to this world. If you were of the world, are you crying that you are hated? It's because you don't belong here. If you were of the world would have loved his own. But because you are not of the world, but I've chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hated you. Rejoice that the world hated you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
John 17, verse 16. This my children are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Are you measuring yourself with the people of this world? Hey, that person buy a car, I must buy the car. That person build a house, I must build the same house. Hey, that man, he's not a Christian, but he just went there, they gave him the word, I must also. You are not like them. Don't measure yourself with the people of this world. You are a stranger here. They are more favorable here, unlike you. The Bible told us in Philippians chapter 3, verse 20 to 21. Philippians 3, 20 to 21. for our citizenship, our conversation. Listen to me, read that care to listen, Greg, listen. For our citizenship, our conversation is in heaven, for which also we eagerly wait for a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 21. Who shall change our vile body? Who shall change this our vile body that we are garnishing? I do everything to make sure this body is making meow, 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 meow like glass. No problem. They are vile body. They are nothing for earthworm. They are nothing for mad dog. Thank God to eat. To feed them. Who shall change our vile body? That it may be fashioned like unto his glorious body. According to the working whereby he is able even to subdue all things under unto himself. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So what do we do? This is our advice. Dearly beloved, I beseech you as strangers and pilgrims. 1 Peter 2 verse 11 and 12. Dearly beloved, I beseech you, I am advising you, I am begging you, as strangers and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lust. Abstain from fleshly lust, which war against your soul. Many things are calling for your attention. Give them not attention.
Amen.
If they put you in everlasting detention in prison in hell. You know why? Because Satan is doing everything to make sure you go to hell. And I'm here to announce to you, you will not go there in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Your amen will say you will go there. Your life amen, inside iniquity, you will go there. If I say amen, make sure you are running away from sin. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Trouble is not by professing it, it's by striving for it. You won. Verse 12. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Verse 12. Having your conversation honest among the Gentiles, among the people of this earth here, that whereas they speak against you as evildoers, they may by your good works, which they shall behold, glorify God in the day of visitation.
Amen.
And they shall see us fly away. That song will come up. If I had known, I would have done what they were doing. This man, I used to call his name, saying it was wasting away. How can you go to Europe? You are wasting away in Europe. For almost 10 years now, you don't have a piece of land. You have nothing. Look at your father's house. You cannot even do anything. A time is coming, they will know that I was doing something.
Amen.
Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When it's coming, they will know who was doing something. If they that were pushing drugs, going from one woman to the other, doing all those nonsense things to show themselves in their village that they are something, we will know who was actually doing something. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There will be shouting in this world. When we have gone, what a happy day. Woe to follow. What a happy day. Come and join us. What a happy day. What a day. What a happy day. When Jesus is the right, I will be shouting. with the work you are doing on earth here, you get to heaven, the Lord will help you to remember everything that went on earth here. But because of the joy of heaven, you will hardly remember the pain went through. I was telling my brother yesterday, if you get to heaven, you will see a man called Jeremiah. After the beauty of Christ, the next most beautiful person of heaven is Jeremiah. Prophet Jeremiah. Why? Because throughout on earth, he was lamenting for God. He was always crying. He was a lamenting prophet. When he died, as he got to heaven, he says, I'm going to beautify you with all the pain you went through on earth for me. With all the lamentation and all you are always crying for Israel. There was never a day where you also laughed. I will make you a laughter in heaven.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is so garnishing that if you see Jesus Christ and if Christ goes and you see Jeremiah, you'll be thinking, this is Christ. Hmm. Because he used beauty, he used smile, he used laughter to garnish him.
Amen.
And you're also weeping now. Sister Roswilliam, I don't know those things you are going through for Christ. When you shall get there, he will beautify you.
Amen.
He will make sure you never, ever, ever, ever. If you see Jeremiah, even if you don't want to smile, you will smile by force. He gave you already made smiling face. He gave you a face that is just is programmed to be smiling.
Amen.
Is programmed to be happy forever and ever. While your father and your mother and your uncle that fall into hell is also programmed to cry for eternity. And now, the tongue of that man, the tongue of that person that fall into hell since 23 years now, so the tongue would have been as long as this. The tongue that should have belonged as my hand now. As you to shout. The more you shout, this tongue is so long. I don't know how God created it. It's when the person gets to hell, he will know how long his tongue is. Hmm. But the shout, Satan will help him or her to draw that tongue out. And make sure this eyeball come out of the socket to be making legger, 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 legger. Yet the eye will still be seen. I'm not exaggerating. It's even more than that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
From that time ago when I went to Spain, I was shown a place in hell that is they grind them as the great cassava, sir. I told you, sir. Okay. The machine I saw. Devil is so wicked. They will put human being inside the machine. They will grind him as the great cassava. If you call man as cassava red with the blood, and at the end you see the person as it's like cassava. The person is crying. It's crying liquid. The person becomes liquid. That's what cassava is. But yet we still hear the voice crying. Don't go to hell. People are saying Apostle Manna is taken out. I will see such a thing. God forbid. They don't know what they're saying. If they know what they're saying, you know nobody will speak this kind of message and want to go there. God forbid.
God forbid.
You know the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
All that is on this voice with all humility. I say, Lord, if you also care, kneel down, go on your knees. I ask God, please, on that day, let your mercy and grace stand for me.
Yes.
I don't want to hell. I don't want to go. I want to go to my place of beauty. I want to be in my citizenship, a seed is waiting for me. You are not a seed of hell. Don't go there. Satan will so baptize you. Satan will grind you as cassava. That man called Satan have no mercy. His delight joy in seeing humanity crying, souls crying. He will cut you as seed. They want to. He will cut you as seed. They want to cook you in pots. And pack it in the pot and start cooking it. Yet the person will not die, will be crying. So Lord, may I not go there. Father, may I not go there. May I not go there. May I not go there. That is not little I see. What that? Don't let your car take you there. Don't let your house take you there. Don't let your job take you there. Don't let your husband take you there. Don't let your
Accept
him as a Lord and Savior. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. Have mercy upon me. I've been plenty in sin for so long, but today I've heard your word. I've decided to leave the devil alone because he was taking me to where he would grind me and destroy me. Lord Jesus, from today you are now my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life and dwell in me. I am born again. Both things have passed away. And all things have become me. Thank you, Father, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be with you, Father. Let this one, O God, be precious to you. On the last day, you welcome them. I should give you the grace today to come to you. Give you the power to stand strong with you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.